how successful Jeff Bezos actually is. Before we start, I want you to hit that red subscribe button so you never miss out on any of our videos. So Amazon, beyond books. The tech visionary graduated from Princeton with a major in computer science and electrical engineering. Upon graduating, he turned down job offers from companies such as Intel and Bell Labs to join a startup called Fitel. He went on to launch a news-by-fax service company with Halsey Miner, the founder of CNET. After the venture failed, Bezos became the youngest senior vice president of a hedge fund called D.E. Shaw, working his way up the ranks in just 4 years. Bezos might have stayed on Wall Street for the rest of his career if he hadn't been enthralled by the knowledge that, by 1994, the internet was growing at the rate of 2,300% annually. Soon enough, his idea for Amazon was born, and the future CEO began making a list of possible product categories to sell online. Amazon.com, then a platform for selling books, grew in its early stages out of a garage with a potbelly stove. Bezos, who put his own $10,000 in the company, comprised of himself, his wife, and two programmers, ironically, conducted most of his meetings at the neighborhood Barnes & Noble. Within its first month after launch in July 1995, Amazon sold books in every state in the US and 45 countries around the world. Beating expectations. During Amazon's first year, Bezos tried to raise money by predicting $74 million in sales by 2000, far underestimating the reality. $1.64 billion in sales in 1999 alone. He managed to gather $1 million in seed funding from angel investors after using up investments from his family, primarily from his parents, who contributed a significant portion of their life savings. The first approximately 20 investors in Amazon put in about $50,000 each for a stake rounded to 1%. Each investment now would be worth approximately $16.71 billion. Representing a roughly 300 times return, given the investors held onto their entire stakes and that they never had been diluted by later investors. In June 1996, Amazon raised another $8 million in Series A from venture capital firm Kleiner Perkins. Amazon went public in May 1997 and turned out to be one of the few startups that survived the dot-com bust. As the platform diversified its product offerings and solidified itself as a market leader and pioneer, annual sales skyrocketed from $500,000 in 1995 to over $3 billion in 2001. In 2013, Bezos revealed his first plans for the company's revolutionary Amazon Prime subscription business, with Amazon Prime Air, which would use drones to deliver to customers. In 1998, Bezos also became an early investor in Google. While he has not revealed what he has kept of the stock after its initial public offering in 2004, his $250,000 investment would be worth billions today. In August 2013, the business mogul bought the Washington Post for $250,000. Since then, its audience and traffic has exploded, surpassing the New York Times in terms of US unique web viewers in October 2015. The company's share price reflects this phenomenal growth. The stock increased over 400% from January 2015 to January 2021, and rose more than 75% between January 2020 to January 2021 alone. Bezos owned about 15.1% of the two-decade-old company as of 2020, making it the largest source of his wealth. Between 2017 and 2019, Bezos sold more than 1 million shares and also distributed additional shares to his ex-wife as part of divorce proceedings. The 2020 annual meeting announcement showed Bezos owning over 75 million shares. Real estate. Bezos also has substantial holdings in more traditional investments such as real estate. His 165,000-acre corn ranch in Texas was acquired as the base of operations for his aerospace company, Blue Origin, and serves as the test site for the vertical landing manned suborbital New Shepard rocket. His personal real estate includes holdings on both the East and West Coast. Bezos has two multi-million dollar homes in Beverly Hills and a 10,000-square-foot apartment in the Century Tower in Manhattan that cost him just under $10 million. Bezos' New York presence is reported to have boosted Century Tower property values even higher, with space selling for $2,000 to $3,000 per square foot. He also has a lakeside property in Washington State, on which he spent $28 million to increase the living space to almost 30,000 square feet. In 2012, Amazon bought its own South Lake Union headquarters in Seattle for $1.5 billion, instantly making the company one of the city's largest commercial property owners. Amazon took possession of nearly a dozen buildings, almost 2 million square feet of office space, and approximately 100,000 square feet of retail space. In August 2017, the Seattle Times reported that Amazon had just as much office space as Seattle's next largest employees, combined. And that's all for today, folks. I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so you never miss another amazing video from us. Until next time.